Hi everyone, it's Vicky here and welcome back. Today I'm going to put into use new products from the latest collection by My Favorite Things. If you want to see the whole collection, I do have an unboxing video, which I'm going to link at the end of this one. Now I will use these border dies. These are perfect for creating waves. I will use these two to create a couple of panels that I can stack one on top of the other. Now that I have the panels ready, I will do some blending. For that I'm using Distress Oxide inks, and I'm starting with Broken China, which is the lightest blue, then I will switch to Salty Ocean, and finally I will use the darkest, which is Blueprint Sketch. I'm going for an ombre effect, which is going to look wonderful for my underwater scene. Now at the top of my panel there, you may see that I have a little boo-boo. That was because I cannot cover up completely the paper. That was because I had washi tape while I was cutting out the paper, and probably it left some residue, but this is not a problem. And I have the same issue here as well. On this piece I'm working on the other side of the paper, and on the other one it's going to be covered with other elements, so I'm not really bothered with that. And you will also notice that I'm switching between different types of blending tools. I am doing that just because I have them and I want to give love to everything, to all the tools that I have in my stash. However, the first one that I used was quite big, so it was better for covering up a bigger area. This one is smaller, and I don't want to cover up the whole page. I just want to stay mainly at the bottom of my C. But really any blending tool that you have would work for this technique. Just make sure that you don't apply too much pressure. Go slowly. Distress Oxide inks are a dream to blend. They are super easy. So no matter what blending tool you have, you will get beautiful results. Now my panels are ready and I absolutely love how they look. Now I'm going to do a really fun technique. I have here a Versamark ink and I'm going to apply some of that ink towards the top where that die cut line is, and then on top of that I'm going to apply some white embossing powder. I'm actually using puffy embossing powder here just to make the foam at the top of the waves, but any white powder would work. I'm doing the same thing on the other panel, and then I'm going to use my heat gun to melt the embossing powder. I'm not going for a perfect look here. The messier, the better. It's going to look really realistic. To complete the look on my background, I'm going to add some water, just some splashes here and there, and then after it reacts with the ink, I'm going to use some clean paper towel and just blot it out. If you like the look, you can add even bigger and more splashes. I'm just happy with how it looks at the moment. I'm going to add some foam tape at the back and then stick this panel on top of the smaller one. This way I have some dimension with waves one on top of the other. Now I'm going to add some foam tape at the bottom of the panel to even it up and stick this panel on top of a pre-folded card. I have one here which is 4.25 by 5.5. And now of course my ocean is ready. All I have to do is to start adding little focal points on top of that using stamps from the Best Fins stamp set. This is the new stamp set from the June release by My Favorite Things. I'm gonna stamp all the images with black extreme ink by My Favorite Things. This is a alcohol friendly ink, so it's not going to smudge or smear, since I'm planning to use my alcohol markers. For coloring all my images today, I'm using my Triblend alcohol markers. These are by Spectrum Noir, and I find them really handy just because in one barrel you get all three shades, light, medium and dark. So I find that it is really quick and easy way to color in your images. And I do have a video review on these markers, which I'm going to link at the end of this one. The green marker that I'm using here is called Alpine Green Blend. Then I will switch into, I have stamped a couple of corals. For the first one I'm using this marker, which is the Burnt Orange Blend. And you can see I'm using the darker shade here to add some shadows, then moving on to the middle shade. Here and there, this is a small image, so you don't really need to do a lot of blending. And finally I will switch to the lighter shade for the tips of my coral. And for the second coral, I'm going to use the coral shades marker. The fun part about these tri-blend markers is that they are super easy to store. You don't have to keep shades that blend nicely together close by. You just throw them in a pencil case, and once you grab a marker, you know that you have already three shades that they are going to work perfectly together. So here are all the images ready to go, and I'm going to use the matching dies to cut them out. I always like to play a little bit with the placement of all the elements, and then once I'm happy, I'm going to stick everything down with my glue. I'm not going to use any foam tape here, everything is going to lay flat on top of my ocean, just because I already have dimension at the back of my waves. For sticking everything down, I'm using my Nouveau Deluxe glue. I am a big fan of this glue just because it grabs really quickly, it never clogs on me, and it has a really fine tip. I used my scissors to cut off any excess paper, just to make sure that everything is nice and neat, and now all I have to do is to stamp the sentiment. For that I'm going to use my Misty, because I have already finished my card and I don't want to make any boo-boos now that everything is done. The sentiment that says sending an ocean of love is from the same stamp set as the rest of the fish, and I'm going to finish it off by sticking some bubbles on top of that. Now when I stick the bubble on top, it's going to look white, however the glue is going to dry clear. And you can see how the card looks at the end, here on the close-up photos. It's a really fun card, super colorful, and I absolutely love underwater scenes. So now let's move on another card, and for this one, I'm going to have my cat Ginger as the focal point. Now the stamp set that I'm using here is called Catastrophe, and it is one from the latest release by My Favorite Things. I'm going to pick one of the cats. I'm also going to stamp a speech balloon and also the fishbowl. So I'm going to create a little scene where Ginger is making a mess. I'm stamping everything with Extreme Black ink pad just because it is alcohol friendly, and I will use my alcohol markers again to color everything. So since I had my tri-blend markers on my table, again I'm using the pink one that is called Pale Pink Shades to color the ears as well as the nose, and I blended out the pink on the ears with a blender marker. And of course I have to color my cat in oranges just because this is supposed to be Ginger. So I'm going to let you see how I did all the coloring, leaving areas white, just like my Ginger is. And of course, keep in mind that just because you have three colors in one marker, that doesn't mean that you can't mix new colors from another marker. So here I'm using two markers, the Burnt Orange blend and the Gold Yellow blend. And I think my cat turned out super adorable. And there is just the fishbowl for me to color. For that I will use the aqua blue blend for the water and the coral shade for the fish. I will use the matching dies to cut out all my images. Now to put my card together, I created this panel using this die. This is an older die by My Favorite Things. It is a peekaboo stitched window. It's one of my favorites, I use it all the time, and you have seen this featured in previous videos for sure. Now I'm going to stamp my sentiment from the same stamp set as the cat, and for that I'm going with embossing ink, and I will apply white embossing powder, heat set it, and I have a lovely sentiment to go with the cat. I used foam tape at the back of my panel to add some dimension, and I placed this panel on top of a pre-folded card that's 4.25 by 5.5. Now I'm going to create my little scene inside that window. I'm going to place the cat first, and then I'm going to add the ball again with foam tape at the back for dimension, but the ball is not going to go straight. I'm going to tilt it a little bit as if the cat is being naughty. I will also stick down the speech bubble, and I did stamp the word meow on top of that. And finally, there is a very small stamp in the stamp set. There are three little lines. Now, this was meant to be stamped with Roomba to give the idea of movement. And that's exactly what I'm going for, on top of the ball, as if it is going to fall. A super adorable card, and I'm sure that if you have a friend with a cat, they absolutely love this one. And of course, make sure to customize the colors of your cat based on the recipient's pet. And for the last card for today, I'm going to use the Baby Shark dies. This is a standalone die, but there are sentiments that match perfectly with this one. Now, the moment I saw this one, I knew exactly what I'm going for. I have a nephew, the son of my brother, who is turning 2 in about a month, and I think this is going to make the perfect birthday card for him. He loves the Baby Shark song, so that's what I'm going for. So I am picking different colors of blue, a darker and a lighter one. I'm also going to cut out the teeth from white, and for the back of the mouth I'm going with black, as well as for the eyes. You can of course use red for the back of the mouth, but I decided to go more subtle here. I am preparing everything on my platform to run it through my die cutting machine, and here are all the pieces ready to go. It's time to put my shark together. For that I will use my Nuvo Deluxe glue, and of course don't forget that you can color your shark any color you like. It's your shark, it's going to live on your card, so why don't you have a pink shark or a green one? It's really up to you. A shark is quite scary, so try to make it as cute as possible. So this is the black piece that I'm going to stick now, which is the inside of the mouth. And of course you can go with pink or red for that if you want to. And then there are indentations exactly where you are supposed to stick this one. Also glue down the eyes and you are ready to go. Now I used the exact same technique as I did for the first card. And I created a nombre look again. I'm adding some splashes. This is a panel that's slightly smaller than a standard card. I'm going to blot it with a paper towel. And I'm adding way more splotches than the first card, just because this is going to be a plain background. I am going to stamp the sentiment and emboss it. That's why I prepared my panel with my anti-static pillow. I'm going with the funniest of the sentiments here. And of course the song was stuck on my head all day. Now I'm going to place my shark on top of my ocean here, but I'm going to show you that it would work on a more embellished background. So you can see here how it would look, and you can have the fin coming out of the waves. But I'm going for a more plain card now. Now, just because this is a card that I'm making for my nephew who is turning 2, I am going to personalize it even more. So I have these dies that cut out balloon numbers. I'm going to cut out the number 2 out of red cardstock. And now it's time to put my card together. Now that die set that cuts out the balloon numbers also cut out little strings, which I have cut out one of those with white cardstock, and I'm going to give this balloon to my shark so he can hold it and take it on the birthday party. And you know I love dimension on my card, so I can't help it. I have to add foam squares at the back of my shark to pop him on the card. And I will do the exact same thing for the number 2. I'm going to bring in my white gel pen and just add some finishing touches like highlights on his eyes, as well as highlights on the balloon and on areas of the shark. And here are some close-up photos on the last card for today. these were all the three cards that I made for today while playing with the latest release by My Favorite Things. I hope that you had fun, that you got inspired. Don't forget to leave me a comment down below and let me know which one of the three cards was your favorite. Just like always, you will find links to everything I used down below in the description area. Thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you all next time.